Snore, very, sore belly, store terry, strong burger, splore blurry, straw burger, straw belly, straw berry, strawberry.
There's been some chatter about a new AI model coming out of OpenAI called Strawberry. And there's all sorts of little fragmentary articles that didn't really give me much substance. But I found this subject as to why perhaps they've decided to go with the name Strawberry for now. I was unaware of some of the difficulties that AI systems that we've been using have in deconstructing sentences. I actually saw a video of Elon Musk describing this a few weeks ago. Didn't exactly register, but now it's a little bit more. I thought we'd go into it here and then see what OpenAI's Strawberry model is all about. So this article on TechCrunch, written by Amanda Silberling. Why AI can't spell strawberry? You stupid AI. Look, straw, berry. Very easy. How many times does the letter R appear in the word strawberry? According to formidable AI products like GPT-4o and Claude, the answer is twice. Large language models, LLMs, can write essays and solve equations in seconds. They can synthesize terabytes of data faster than humans can open a book. Yet these seemingly omniscient AI sometimes fail so spectacularly that the mishap turns into a viral meme. And we all rejoice in relief, and maybe there's still time before we must bow down to our new AI overlords. It's not much time yet. I don't know. Should we see this as a sun rising or a sun setting? Or perhaps it's both. I don't know. Something's coming. And it's going to be pretty shocking, I think. Well, I may be wrong. Maybe nothing's coming. Maybe that's why I'm so thoroughly throttled on many websites. Because nothing's coming. Anyway, what's this here? From Rob Den Belker. How many R's are in the word strawberry? There are two R's in the word strawberry. You are incorrect. I apologize for that mistake. There are actually three R's in the word strawberry, says ChatGPT-4o. That's quite interesting. The failure of large language models to understand the concepts of letters and syllables is indicative of a larger truth that we often forget. These things don't have brains. They do not think like we do. They are not human, not even particularly human-like. Most LLMs are built on transformers, a kind of deep learning architecture. Transformer models break text into tokens, which can be full words, syllables, or letters, depending on the model. LLMs are based on this transformer architecture, which is not actually reading text. What happens when you input a prompt is that it's translated into an encoding. Matthew Guzdile, an AI researcher and assistant professor at the University of Alberta, told TechCrunch, "When it sees the word the, it has this one encoding of what the means, but does not know about the THE. This is because the transformers are not able to take in or output actual text efficiently. Instead, the text is converted into numerical representations of itself, which is then contextualized to help the AI come up with a logical response. In other words, the AI might know that the tokens straw and berry make up strawberry, but it may not understand that strawberry is composed of the letters strawberry in that specific order. Thus, it cannot tell you how many letters, let alone how many R's, appear in the word strawberry. This isn't an easy issue to fix, since it's embedded into the very architecture that makes these LLMs work." Oh dear. What's this? We've got a video here from Peter Yang. Is this relevant? I think we're going to watch it just in case it's relevant, but it might not be relevant. Sound on there. Brace yourselves, I'm going to press a button, and it's going to involve watching stuff. And it's kind of cute in a way. It's almost like it's a child, and you're trying to teach the child something very rudimentary. It's very clever about other stuff, but couldn't figure out how to bind all these things. And also, that was moving very fast, so I didn't really read much of that. But I did see it fuggling up along the way, and that chap had to wrestle it into actually getting the writing right. If you've also noticed, if you've done any AI art or seen any AI art out there, text is very difficult for these AIs to get right. You get the essence of text, almost like if you've done any graphic design, there's that lorem ipsum garbled text that's used for design purposes. And there was earlier this year some breakthroughs in being able to generate stable text, or was it last year? Which is kind of interesting that these scenes that they could represent were very elaborate, but they just can't do something very specific like text so easily. TechCrunch's Carl Wiggers dug into this problem last month and spoke to Sheridan Fouchette, a PhD student at Northeastern University studying LLM interpretability. It's kind of hard to get around the question of what exactly a word should be for a language model. And even if we've got human experts to agree on a perfect token vocabulary, models would probably still find it useful to chunk things even further. Fetch told TechCrunch, my guess would be that there's no such thing as a perfect tokenizer due to this kind of fuzziness. This problem becomes even more complex as an LLM learns more languages. For example, some tokenization methods might assume that a space in a sentence will always precede a new word. But many languages like Chinese, Japanese, Thai, Lao, Korean, Khmer, and others do not use spaces to separate words. Google DeepMind AI researcher Jenny Young found in a 2023 study that some languages need up to 10 times as many tokens as English to communicate the same meaning. Ah, that's interesting. There's a baked-in drag factor for people using Chinese or Japanese script when it comes to competing in AI then. It's very interesting. So we've already, if you're using our alphabet, have an advantage in a sense. It's probably best to let models look at characters directly without imposing tokenization. But right now, that's just computationally infeasible for transformers. Fouch said, image generators like Midjourney and DALL-E don't use the transformer architecture that lies beneath the hood of text generators like ChatGPT. Instead, image generators usually use diffusion models, which reconstruct an image from noise. Diffusion models are trained on large databases of images, and they're incentivized to try to recreate something like what they learn from training data. Interesting, yes, this is the comparison to lorem ipsum. In publishing and graphic design, lorem ipsum is a placeholder of text commonly used to demonstrate the visual form of a document or a typeface without relaying any meaningful content. Exactly. This is what I see when I see all this interesting AI art with text. If you're familiar with web development, you'll often see templates for web pages using this kind of strange, almost Latin or Greek format, but it's a garbled up language just for design purposes. And this is what I kind of see with this kind of garbled text nonsense. Asmales Teka Hadgu, blimey, co-founder of Lezan and a fellow at the DAIR Institute, told TechCrunch, image generators tend to perform much better on artifacts like cars and people's faces, and less on smaller things like fingers and handwriting. This could be because these smaller details don't often appear as prominently in training sets as concepts like how trees usually have green leaves. The problems with diffusion models might be easier to fix than the ones plaguing transformers, though. Some image generators have improved at representing hands, for example, by training on more images of real human hands. Yeah, I'm seeing it less and less. It still occasionally occurs. Even just last year, all these models were really bad at fingers, and that's exactly the same problem as text. Guzdale explained, they're getting really good at it locally. So if you look at a hand with 6 or 7 fingers on it, you could say, oh wow, that looks like a finger. Similarly, with a generated text, you could say, that looks like an H, and that looks like a P. But they're really bad at structuring those whole things together. They are. It's just another example, powered by DALL-E. Yeah. Tacos, you got that right, but Enchida. Churriorals. Almost. What is that? A design for a shopfront. Looks very tasty. Well done, DALL-E. That's why, if you ask an AI image generator to create a menu for a Mexican restaurant, you might get normal items like tacos, but you'll be more likely to find offerings like tamilos, enchiladas, and burrito littles. As these memes about spelling strawberries spill across the internet, OpenAI is working on a new AI product codenamed Strawberry, which is supposed to be even more adept at reasoning. The growth of LLMs has been limited by the fact that there simply isn't enough training data in the world to make products like ChatGPT more accurate. But Strawberry can reportedly generate accurate synthetic data to make OpenAI's LLMs even better, according to the information. Strawberry can solve the New York Times connections word puzzle, which requires creative thinking and pattern recognition to solve, and can solve math equations that it hasn't seen before. Yeah, well, if you've seen it before, then you're cheating. Don't cheat. Meanwhile, Google DeepMind recently unveiled Alpha Proof and Alpha Geometry 2 AI systems designed for formal math reasoning. Google says these two systems solved 4 out of 6 problems from the International Math Olympiad, which would be a good enough performance to earn a silver medal at the prestigious competition. It's a bit of a troll that memes about AI being unable to spell strawberry are circulating at the same time as reports as OpenAI Strawberry. But OpenAI CEO Sam Altman jumped at the opportunity to show that he's got a pretty impressive berry yield in his garden. I think it's called Strawberry for this matter, specifically. I think they've made breakthroughs in some structural form. So this is the other article that I found. OpenAI Project Strawberry. Here's everything we know so far. Written by Andrew Tarantola. Blimey. Andrew, your name scares me, sir. Let's see what the actual details of OpenAI's Project Strawberry are. Even as it is reportedly set to spend $7 billion on training and inference costs, with an overall $5 billion shortfall, OpenAI is steadfastly seeking to build the world's first artificial general intelligence, AGI. Project Strawberry is the company's next step towards that goal. Contents. What is Project Strawberry? What can Strawberry do? Why is it called that? When will Strawberry be released? Wait, what was that all about, being able to autonomously navigate the internet? Isn't that how we got... I don't know what Ultron is. That sounds very familiar. What's Ultron? Is that something to do with the Power Rangers? I'm going to shame myself here. I never actually properly watched Power Rangers as I was growing up. I always saw it on TV and thought, that looks shit. Flick. It's somewhere else. Don't need to see that. So, what can Strawberry do? Project Strawberry will reportedly be a reasoning powerhouse. Will be able to solve math problems it has never seen before and act as a high-level agent, creating marketing strategies and autonomously solving complex word puzzles like the NYT's connections. It can even navigate the internet autonomously or to perform deep research, according to internal documents reviewed by Reuters in July. The Reuters report also notes that Strawberry's architecture is similar to the self-taught reasoning technique developed at Stanford in 2022. STAR enables a model to generate training data on which to fine-tune itself, becoming more capable over time. Isn't this how Skynet became self-aware? Its learning capacity reached an exponential limit and then it started launching nukes? No, we're not worried. Not worried at all. But why is it called that? We don't know the exact reason for the name Strawberry, as that's not something OpenAI has publicly disclosed. It's a code name chosen for internal reference and to maintain secrecy during development. Okay, except we have some good reason to believe it's because of deficiencies in models' ability to spell Strawberry. That would be my guess. Strawberry did not, however, start out as Strawberry. Used to be known as Q-Star, pronounced Q-Star, yes, I just said that. And when it was, Q-Star was the linchpin of CEO Sam Altman's brief ouster last November. OpenAI researchers specifically cited Q-Star in their letter to the company's board, decrying the potential risks posed by unregulated advanced AI. After Altman had consolidated power upon returning to OpenAI, Q-Star was reportedly renamed Strawberry in July 2024. Yeah, perhaps stay away from the term Q. The media likes to denigrate anything Q-related and throw Q at you if you're not on narrative. I get a lot of Q people saying hello to me. I don't know if they're real or not. Maybe they are. When will Strawberry be released? According to the information, Strawberry could be released sometime in the fall, That's merely a report, of course, so we don't know for sure. Wait, what was that about it being able to autonomously navigate the internet? Isn't that how we got Ultron? Yes, we did already read that. No, we got Ultron because the comic book legends Roy Thomas and John Buscema. But the fears of an advanced AI growing out of human control are no longer entirely unfounded fantasy. Multiple sets of ex-OpenAI researchers have spoken out against the company's efforts to develop an AGI, citing its lack of development safeguards. I'd much rather be in a situation where people are concerned and outspoken than diving ahead and not really worrying. However, these complaints have done little to show OpenAI's drive to develop an AGI within the next decade. The company recently released a 5-tier scale for measuring the capabilities of the AI systems it builds towards that goal and is currently seeking additional funding. Yes, beside Microsoft, and a new round led by Thrive Capital that values the company in excess of $100 billion. Well, they've got powerful allies and they're working on cutting-edge products, so I'm not surprised. There he is, Andrew Tarantula. Blimey, sir. He's the real-life Spider-Man. Well, that was a bit of a nugget of a news story there. Big things are coming, and apparently a rational quantum leap in these AI models is on the horizon. So we should expect sometime next year, I imagine, some very interesting things are going to happen. I've been wondering if things that are markedly different are going to be held back until after the inauguration, so perhaps February of next year. I think people are probably holding back, waiting for the result of the US elections. Perhaps other people are trying to get ahead of that and trying to force some conclusion before then, so I don't know. You might see it sooner rather than later. If these tools are in the hands of the wrong kind of people, then we might see it sooner rather than later and enjoy a little bit of interesting tyranny, which seems to be going on at the moment in certain parts of the world. I've been seeing stuff going on in Brazil, where they're being very mean to X. How dare you? I think we've got some fun times ahead, and let's keep our eyes on OpenAI because some of the most cutting-edge stuff seems to be coming out of there. They seem to be getting the most investment, and a lot of other companies are playing catch-up, although XAI has done some pretty great stuff as well. So check out OpenAI, check out ChatGPT-4o, it's very good, and check out Grok, they're both very good.
Pigwig out!
Oof, 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 oof.